So in this lecture, we are going to start with new test design technique, that is cause-effect graphing. So let's see what is the meaning of cause-effect graph. Cause-effect graphs may be generated from any source which describes the functional logic of a program. So if you have a program which has functional logic in it, that means rules, steps, then you can apply cause-effect graph on it. For an example, if you have a user story, because user story contains logical order of steps, where first step will be defined, depending upon the first step, the second step will be defined. If first step is not executed, second step you will not reach. So it is arranged in a logical order. And you also know about flowchart. Flowchart is also logical arrangement of the steps, of the requirement. So for these type of requirements, you can apply cause-effect graph. And this point is very important. If you have a user story or flowchart or a program which has a functional logic, you can apply cause-effect graph on it. Now the next question comes, what will happen if you apply a cause-effect graph? Then you will get the graphical overview of program's logical structure. If it is written in the form of text, sometimes it is very difficult to visualize it. But cause-effect graph will provide you the graphical overview of that logical structure. And if you can visualize by seeing the cause-effect graph, then you can write a better test case. Now moving towards the third point, that is, cause-effect graphs is also useful for creating decision tables. So here what you need to know is, if you have a cause-effect graph, you can derive a decision table out of it. Similar way, if you have a decision table, then you can create a cause-effect graph, and that we will see with an example in the next lecture. And before we end this lecture, the last and the important point is capturing decisions as cause-effect graph or decision tables enables systematic test coverage of the program's logic to be achieved. If you have a program logic which has a logical structure, and if you draw a cause-effect graph out of it, then you can provide a systematic test coverage, because you are able to visualize it properly. You know which all combinations are there, and for that you will write the test case. By doing that, you are providing a systematic test coverage. And with this lecture ends, and I will see you with the next lecture, that is nothing but the cause-effect graph example.